In the event that you receive a spreadsheet with time value separated, as in the hour, minute, and seconds, all in separate columns, you can use the time function to construct the time. So the time function uses these three inputs, the hour, minute, and second, to return a time value. So Excel sees time as a decimal that represents a fraction of a day. These range from 0 for 12 a.m. to 0.99 for 11:59 p.m. So once you create the time, you can format it using any of the time formats or as a decimal if you need to use it in other calculations. And let's format it using this format so we can see the seconds. So if any of these inputs are missing, so how you see here, the second is missing, the minute is missing, that defaults to 0. But when the hour input is missing, it will default to 12 a.m. as 12 a.m. is hour 0 of a 24-hour day. So that's just something to be aware of as you're using the time function to construct time. If you need to instead separate a time value into the hour, minute, second inputs, you can do that with the hour, minute, and second functions. And with that, all you have to do is type, for example, equals hour, and reference the time format or your decimal value and hit enter. For minute, you would type equals minute and reference the time value, and likewise for second, you would simply type second and reference the time value. Now, important to note is this has to reference a time value. Notice that if I try to reference these other integers that are not a decimal value or part of the time formatting yet, we don't get the correct result. Let's just copy these down. So with the hour, minute, and second function, it's not necessary to reference another value. You can always type your own. For example, if you'd like to enter an hour, you would write equals hour, and then in quotation marks, write your desired hour. So let's say you want to do 8 o'clock. Now, one thing to keep in mind with these functions is they reference a 24-hour clock and will give you results in military time. So unless you specify that 8 should be p.m., it will default to 8 a.m. So to display an 8 p.m., you could either type 20 hours or type the number 8, a space, and follow that with p.m., and your result will be 20 hours. So because the hour, minute, and second function work off a 24-hour day, 60-minute hour, and 60-second minute, if you enter a value greater than those, it will roll over to the next day, hour, or minute. So for example, if I were to type 75 minutes, because there's only 60 minutes in an hour, it will actually display 15 minutes. And if you want to enter your own value for second, you would do the same thing, making sure to format it correctly. So with these functions, even though the values roll over, you can still calculate the total hours, minutes, and second simply by summing your values. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.